Hey guys, it's me, Jose. Today, I'd like to talk about a friend named Ivan. He's a great friend who means everyone well and tries to be the best person that he can. He has survived a heart attack and he believes that he is living his second life and he intends to live it out as best and as open as he can. But of course, everyone has their own secrets and Ivan wants to share his to everybody. I'm about to tell you a few of the many things Ivan has under his sleeves. We all know that he likes sneakers, but every time he buys one, he absolutely loves to smell the inside of it. He puts ketchup on almost everything. He has always been a fan of LeBron James. He has no idea how to swim. He loves dogs. He never drinks soft drinks. Instead, he prefers Vitamilk and juice. He always works hard for what he wants. He loves to speak in English, even if he knows his grammar might be wrong.
No, it isn't.
He would, quote unquote, sacrifice everything for a pair of Yeezys. He has a mutation in his heart. He has always been in love with reading. The first thing he finds attractive in a girl is her eyes. He has been an Immaculadista for 9 years. But San Carlos still has a special place in his mutated heart. He is at 200 pounds and counting. Okay, now let's talk about his hobbies. We all know he loves basketball and badminton. But little did you know, he does videos on YouTube. His channel, Fry TV, has over 100 subscribers. It may not be as big as many others, but it's a good start. His favorite movies are Adam Sandler's comedies.
Why don't these guys know how to jump rope? Why didn't you teach them? We were the double Dutch king.
And he spends a lot of time doing computer stuff. He does hate a few things though, like carrots, traveling, the Golden State Warriors, and Vitamilk. Well, that's all he has to share. He might still have more secrets, but let's leave something for the imagination.
What's up guys, I'm here also to talk about my friend Jose. He's been a great friend to me since the 8th grade and always does his best in everything that he does. He is an editor for the school paper, which I really like to read sometimes. I may have known him for a while, but Jose has secrets and he wants to share it to everyone. I'm about to tell you some right now. He taught himself how to play the piano. He sleeps with the piano beside his bed. If he can't sleep, he plays the piano until he feels tired. He sometimes sleeps with the light on. He absolutely hates the smell of coffee, but he thinks that durian smells fragrant. When he was younger, he chewed holes in his blanket. He has a pet hamster named Kiev. Credits to Anjali for the name. He plays League of Legends. He plays Pump Fiesta on Sundays with his sister. He is the tallest person in his family. He has a 25/20 vision. His IQ is 142. He loves all kinds of cheeses. He is afraid of the dark. He loves making puns. He has mild epilepsy and takes medications that make him forgetful. He is afraid of needles, unless he's sewing. He absolutely hates alcohol and the smell of it as well. His great-great-grandfather is Arcadio Maximum, the man who Maximum Avenue is named after. He has eaten stingrays, turtles, a baby shark, tree worms, a baby alligator, snakes, and eels. He has lived in Manila and was fluent in Tagalog for the first 7 years of his life. Then he moved to Cebu. He has G6PD, meaning he can't eat too many legumes or sniff mothballs. Also, if he drinks aspirin, he would die. He has only a single crush in his entire life, and she knows who she is. That's all I have for Jose right now. Maybe he has more secrets, but he is afraid to share them. Hope you learned something from him today.
John Lloyd is a really talkative person and is open about a lot of things. This makes it seem that we already know a lot about him. But do we? Let's start off with some of John Lloyd's general facts. He was born on June 8th of 2000. He is an only child. He was raised in Arega, Cebu City. Yes, he was there when the 2014 fire broke loose in the area. Luckily, their house wasn't affected greatly by the fire. As we all know, he is talkative and has a good sense of humor. His mother and father are both self-employed. Now let's talk about his likes and dislikes. He likes the smell of ink from a marker. He likes the dark. He likes rap music. He hates spiders. He dislikes spicy food. He also dislikes ice cream. He is very protective towards his mom. Although it might not seem like it, he is very good at playing basketball. When he was in grade school, he was part of the basketball varsity team. He is a really big fan of LeBron James.
Now the Cavs have to go 94 feet. Kevin Love down the floor for LeBron James on target. Turns, sends it. LeBron. Yeah! You gotta be kidding me! Life is about to over!
He is also really good at takyan and sepak. He is a foodie. He has a phobia of spiders and dogs. He is a sneakerhead. He buys a lot of shoes and knows a lot about them as well. He wants to become a doctor someday. He enjoys walking. He is good at speaking in Filipino. He skates. He has an interest in cinematography. He doesn't know how to swim or ride a bike. He likes Captain America. These are just some of the facts that we may or may not know about him. Who will know for sure if he has more to hide? That is all I have to share. Thanks for watching.
Beautiful morning, yeah, the summer morning, babe. Nothing in the water.
This is Joshua Daniel B. Nazareno. He is 16 years old, and he was born on November 9, 2000. His father works overseas. and his mother is a barangay secretary. He has one very cute and talkative younger brother. He likes skateboarding and is a huge basketball fan. He is also skilled in playing musical instruments and drawing.
I know you guys already know Joshua, but there are a lot of things that you don't know about him. And I'll be sharing to you things to help you get to know Joshua more. He was born and raised in Pilais Extension Ramos, Cebu City.
He is a Lola's boy because he is very close to his grandmother since he was a little child. When he was young, he tripped and hit his head on a sharp edge of a table. He got stitches for it, and the doctor said he got very lucky that his skull was not injured.
He travels a lot within Cebu City province because his parents are really into having adventures and bonding with family.
Although it might not seem like it, but he loves his younger brother a lot.
He was very fat in his grade school years. Joining the Arnis team changed his figure. Here are the things that Joshua likes. The genre of music he likes is EDM. He likes watching movies. He loves the smell of gasoline. He likes silence. And he's a big fan of Kobe Bryant.
Artest looking, gets it to Bryant. Bryant dribbling, has to put it up with the buzzer. Banks it in! Ha-ha! He banks in the three!
And here are the things that Joshua doesn't like. He doesn't like chorizo. He hates horror and gore movies. He doesn't like dust and allergic to it. He doesn't like dark places.
Turn off the lights! Turn off the lights! Turn off the lights! Turn them off!
Hey guys, so today I'm going to talk about one of the most precious people in my life, Danielle Elisha Asdilio. She was born on December 6, 2000 at 9:51 p.m., weighing at 7 pounds. She always cut her hair short when she was young. When Danielle was a kid, she had straight hair, but when she reached grade 6, it became curly. When Danielle was young, she had a bad fall from her bed, which caused her scoliosis. The curvature of her spine at the beginning was 45 degrees, but it gradually improved to 25 degrees. Danielle first drank alcohol during the 6th grade. Did you know that Danielle is allergic to crabs? Well, she is! Out of all the existing vegetables, she never liked eating carrots. Of all the fruits, she doesn't eat jackfruit because she doesn't like the smell. Danielle is one of the skinniest people in the classroom, but did you know that she can finish 3 cups of rice in Mang Inasal? Her greatest fears are frogs, cockroaches, and lizards. Daniel likes pasta. I mean, everything that's pasta. One of the weirdest things I know about her is that she likes eating ice. Her favorite color is pink. Daniel's favorite TV show is The Vampire Diaries, and her favorite actor is Ian Somerhalder, who plays Damon on the show. One of the things that Daniel loves is money, and she also loves the smell of it. One of the things that make her happy are sunsets. She is very ticklish. She is ticklish on almost all the parts of her body. She sings out loud when she's taking a bath. Daniel knows a lot of things, but she doesn't know how to whistle or snap her fingers. Daniel can't sleep without hugging a pillow. You probably don't know that she combs her hair only every weekend. She always arranges her things, because if they aren't arranged, she gets irritated. Because of this, she can spend hours arranging her things so that it looks the way she wants. She loves coffee, although it can give her heart palpitations. She has a weird addiction of gift wrappers, silver dust, Polaroids, and coins from other countries. That's all I can share to you guys for now. I can truly say that I am very lucky to have someone as caring, understanding, crazy, weird, and funny like her in my life.
This is my partner. We have been best friends for 3 years and have shared a special connection with each other. But I believe that there are still a lot of things that I don't know about her. And now is the time to get to know her more and share these things with you. Ana Michaela Relativo, or simply Ana. She was born on November 20, 2000 at 8:45 a.m. in Iloilo Doctors Hospital. She lived there for 10 years. We commonly call her Ana in school, but her family calls her Mika. What a cute name! When she was young, she once didn't answer an exam in kindergarten, and her reason was because her brain couldn't take it. What a naughty girl. She has a pillow named Smooch. She had him since she was 3. She believes that she is born to sing nursery rhymes. She even records herself and sends voice messages to her friends.
Out came the sun and dried up all the rain, and itsy bitsy spider went up the
Moving on, you may know her as a tough and brave girl, the girl you don't want to mess with. But what you do not know is that she is afraid of a lot of things and has a lot of allergies. First, she is allergic to soap. Her dermatologist only allows her to use baby soaps like Johnson's and Cetaphil. If she uses Safeguard, she will have rashes all over her body. She is also allergic to crabs, shrimps, and lobsters. She can't stand horror movies. Whenever she watches one, she takes off her glasses so she wouldn't see what's going on and put on her earphones and play music. She hates heights, because whenever she's at a high place, she feels like she's falling down. She cries a lot. She cries listening to her friends' problems. She cries watching movies. She hates spiders. They are her biggest fears. Now, let's move on to the things that she likes that you probably don't know. She loves ice cream and cheese, but her stomach will get hurt whenever she eats them because she is lactose intolerant. She loves dancing, but unfortunately, dancing didn't help her. She dances in time zone. She even joined the hip-hop competition when she was still in grade 6 and grade 7. She loves reading, and she has over 300 novels that she has bought with her own money. She eats all kinds of vegetables because she loves them. She can live on just eating pizza. She loves pizza so much. Another thing that you probably don't know about Anna is that she doesn't like anything pork. She does her best to avoid eating it. She hates buko juice. Whenever she presents in front of the class, she always holds her hanky because it makes her feel safe. She also doesn't know how to hold a grudge. Whenever she gets mad, she feels better after a few hours. All you need is give her a little space. She is shy to the people she's not close with. But when you get closer, she's loud as ever. Anna is the perfect example of a watermelon because she is strong, tough, and brave outside. But she also has a gentle and sweet personality. Being both soft and strong is a combination very few have mastered. And one of them is Anna.
Subscribe to our channel and see you guys next time!
Hi, my name is Maurice, and here is my beautiful best friend, Rosette. You may know her as a girl who looks so quiet and holy that sometimes it makes us think that she has the qualities to be a nun or a saint. We may also know her as a girl who laughs her heart out at things that sometimes aren't that funny. But there are a lot of things that you still don't know about her. Rosette Clarissa Lazar was born on March 20, 2000. When she got out of her mother's womb, the people in the room thought that she was dead. She did not cry or whatsoever. So, what the doctor did was give her a spank in the butt, and she cried. She met her dad for the first time when she was just 3 years old, due to the complicated relationship of her parents. Rosette is different from other kids. She didn't like cartoons when she was little. Instead, she liked watching horror movies. The first horror movie she watched was The Exorcist. Did you know that she was a swimmer when she was a kid? She started swimming when she was 4. And throughout her career, she garnered 3 golds, 1 silver, and 1 bronze. Rosette has the ability to see ghosts. The first ghost she saw was his best friend named Julius. She was only 4 years old at that time. She even asked him why he was so pale, yet he just smiled. The day after that, Julius' mom called Rosette's mom, informing them that Julius died 2 days ago. Rosette is a huge fan of spicy foods. She loves to eat silly, kimchi, or anything spicy whenever she gets sleepy or stressed. She also loves to eat the desserts first before she eats the main course. She is also a big K-pop and K-drama fan. She loves anything Korean. She even has a scrapbook filled with her favorite K-pop idols, K-dramas, and groups. She went to her very first concert last December. She did not eat lunch for the whole November just to save up money for the concert ticket. Crazy, right? Due to her love for Korean culture, she started learning Korean last May 2016. It takes her a long time to step on the escalator because when she was a kid, she tripped over it and broke her collarbone. And she never likes lechon and humbug. Back when she was a kid, she has a great fear of deep waters. This is because of her experience when she had almost drowned in the sea. Due to extreme excitement, she did not wait for her mom and ran to the shore. Due to this experience, her mom let her took swimming lessons and it made her overcome her fear of deep waters, and she even collected medals from swimming competitions. So that's it, and I hope you learned something new about my best friend, Rosette.
There is always that one person in life that seems to be the other half of you. For me, that person is my one and only best friend, Maurice Babes Titaytayan, Babies for short. She's the type of person who is focused and well-driven in everything she does. But behind that seriousness is a bubbly, cheerful, and a goofy person. Well, here are some things you don't know much about her. She was born on May 23, 2000 in Cebu City. Her name Maurice originated from her two grandmothers, Maura and Rizalina. Her name Babes originated from her mom's nickname, Baby. Her original name was actually Maurice Baby, but her mom changed it to Maurice Babes. She was a sickly child. It is a part of a Masbatanyo belief that the solution of her sickly condition was to change her name. Her name was supposed to be Femi. Oh, Femi! I can't imagine calling her that. But her mom decided not to because it sounded weird. Her parents and relatives thought that she was a mute because she couldn't say any word until she was 2 years old. She had swimming lessons back in 2008 and 2009. Although she has a background in swimming, she still fears swimming across deep waters. Did you know that she prefers medicines in syrup than in tablets? She can't swallow tablets because she fears that she might choke. She loves playing volleyball. She loves anything that is color white. For her, the perfect combination is white and gold. Did you know that she loves action movies? She dreamt of becoming a police or a secret agent back then. She used to be a huge fan of Taylor Swift. She'd memorize all her songs. She'd jump, look herself in the mirror, and sing out loud, as if she was having a concert with her idol Taylor Swift. She was so inspired by her to the point that she dreamt of becoming a performer. She hates raisins and a taste of whipped cream. Weird, right? Did you know that she is afraid of dogs? It was due to an incident back when she was still a kid. She stared at dog's eyes and ran as fast as she could to the gate. But she wasn't fast enough to escape, so she got bitten by the dog. But when her uncle got a dog as a gift, it slowly erased that fear of hers towards dogs. So that's pretty much it. That's just some of the things I can share about my beautiful best friend, Bubbies.
Here are some things you might not know about Angelique Eway.
Since she was in kindergarten, she started to swim because her mom wanted her to learn how to swim so she wouldn't end up like her brother, who is afraid of the water. So after getting a little taste of what swimming is, she stopped so she can join singing. But then she got back to swimming for 2 summers and joined contests in Sacred Heart Center. All in all, she had 1 gold, 1 silver, and 3 bronze medals. But then she didn't pursue swimming because there wasn't any opportunity in school, or not that she had known of. From swimming, let's go to her singing talent. So since kindergarten, she has had many singing lessons. Her parents discovered her talent when she was randomly singing something. Plus, she would always win the contest of longest voice. She had a total of 3 different singing coaches, 7 culminating performances, and only 1 contest joined, which kind of discouraged her on joining contests again or even singing on stage. It was grade 5 when she was given the chance of joining Himig Pinoy, and towards the end of the song, her voice failed. Her mom didn't want people to laugh at her, so she told her not to join again, so she followed what her mom said. Aside from singing and swimming, she also loves writing. Being a Wattpad author was an inspiration from reading other Wattpad stories. It started when she read pop fiction books, which she came to love so easily. So she thought of writing her own story. Something that is new and something that people might want to read too. That is when Sweet Revenge came to life. The title of her story later changed into My Campus King, Royal Rivalry. The characters, of course, would have a hint of her attitude, since she's the author and there's nothing more influential than herself. She used to space out in classes when she was at grade 7, just so she could think of new happenings in the story. She is really an active person. However, did you know that she also has allergies like me? She doesn't really know why she has this. Every time dust and heat mix, red spots show up on her face and it would itch. The only cure she has ever known was to go in an air-conditioned room and take the aircon all for herself. Let's get to know what her favorite show is. She really loves Adventure Time, and she has memorized all the songs and all the characters and all the episodes from season 1 to 4. She had made a scrapbook about it. She has even memorized 1 whole episode as if she was the voice of all the characters. But all of these are in the past, since she got too busy to even turn on the TV. How sad. Speaking of adventure, Angelie really had a good time in her childhood. Quite boyish, I might say. In her neighborhood, she was the only girl who frequently goes out to play because of her brother, who would force her to play basketball with him. She was this boyish type of girl at home because of her brother, but she tries not to show this in school. Oh, and she's a huge fan of the LA Lakers. She bleeds purple and gold. Now let's ponder on the other things she's a fan of. Once, she had a room full of stuffed animals. Yes, she's allergic to dust, but nobody can stop her from collecting stuffed animals. She would know all of their names and gather them for a meeting when she's home alone and bored. She loves animals, and her ultimate goal was to volunteer in WWF. Since she's not allowed to have pets yet, she dwells on stuffed ones. Now, who would have thought that she would love broccoli? Oh, she just loves the taste. Only vegetable in her life. There are other things she loves to eat. Every time you eat at Jollibee and it is lunchtime, expect that this girl would order burger steak paired with spaghetti. This seems to be her 1-2 punch combo in Jollibee. She also seems so comforted when she eats the meal, and she seems so happy about it. Although her favorites are in Jollibee, if there is any mascot inside, she wouldn't eat there. She says that its face is weird and that it has a hidden agenda. You can never put Anjali and the Jollibee mascot side by side. Nope. From her food interests, let's go to her reading hobbies. It was in the grade 8 when I discovered that she likes pop fiction books. I even gave her a pop fiction book on her 14th birthday. She has gathered a lot, and when I say a lot, I mean lots and lots of books. I could not even imagine reading all of those. She collects them and puts them in a box. Wattpad books are made by Philippine authors, which inspires her even more. Yes, books are cool, but Anjali has always been sporty and active. She joined the tryouts for athletics because her best friend did so. Her mom doesn't want her to join, and her dad slightly thinks it's a good thing that she has a sport to join. She was dedicated in practices unless she really needed to skip practice for school matters. But then, something really bad happened. She broke her arm 2 days before the Cebu City Olympics. She cried so hard that she can't join the games and that all her efforts would be wasted. She kept asking if she could still play even if she knew she couldn't. She still wanted to join athletics when she has recovered, but her mom strongly disapproved. From her athletic side, let's go to her sleeping habits. Her dad said that watching TV before sleeping is one of the causes of her insomnia. She always had problems in sleeping, especially when she doesn't feel like it. She couldn't sleep unless she has read a good book before sleeping or studied something. Sleeping was like magic for her before. She never knew when she'd fall asleep. She would just be thankful that she woke up, meaning she fell asleep at who knows what time. Back to books again. Now, we can see that she really loves books. She wouldn't stop reading her book no matter what, unless it is to ponder on what she has read. She even tried reading in the bathroom because of her mom. She scolded her and told her to go to bed. She also tried telling her mom that she had a headache so she could stay home and finish a book.
Things that you do not know about Arnold Joshua Takuya. It was during his first and second grade in elementary, he was forced by his mom to attend singing lessons at Center for Pop because his mom said that he had a good voice and he believed her wholeheartedly. He would show up only around once a month because he never had interest in singing, and he almost joined a competition but refused to do so. Aside from singing, this guy also had the dancing spirit during his elementary days. The school participated in APSEM during those days, and Arnold decided to join hip-hop. Though he had no passion for hip-hop, he still tried to fit in. They became the second runner-up at the hip-hop competition. Despite his handful of activities participated, did you know that he is an introvert? He was an extrovert, but that slowly transformed to him becoming an introvert, and he really can't pinpoint when that happened. Opposite to his being noisy and foolish before, he became the silent type. Well, that's what he said at least. A fact that most of us know of Arnold is that he was chubby back at his elementary days. What we do not really know of is the fact that he got body shamed. Since he was a kid, he already had a large figure. His mom would often call him a huge ball of shopao. After quite a number of humiliations because of his fatty figure, he decided to change his eating habits and have regular exercise. This is where he joined the basketball team, and during lunch, he would only eat apples to have a good diet. Speaking of basketball, he was a varsity player then. His passion for basketball all started at grade 5. At first, he was very shy during practices, but time passed and in grade 6, he took part in the training and was selected as a starting 5 for the Cebu Elite Championship against UV. They won the championship and that became the highlight of him being a player. Though in grade 7, something bad happened that changed his life. It was August of 2013. After their practice, he and his friend decided to have a dunk contest on the smaller rink. When he dunked, he fell left hand first. He thought he only had a sprained wrist, but it was already something bad. This was the reason he stopped being a varsity player in basketball. He did try to move on from this sudden turn of events, as something funny happened to him on December 2011. Arnold, together with his siblings, were going on a trip to Korea. On the day of the flight, lacking the DSWD clearance, he got left behind for a day. But when he finally got his turn in riding the plane to Korea, it turned out to be a fun experience after all. When people are happy, they would discover things that they love. One thing that Arnold loves is ramen. His taste for ramen started when he and his family went to a restaurant called Yushoken. The ramen they serve is the best, according to him. The second thing that he came to love was Harry Potter. His brothers and sisters were always a fan of Harry Potter, but Arnold didn't appreciate it that much yet, since he did not understand the story. When he decided to watch the whole movie series during grade 8, he became a huge fan. He watched Harry Potter every Christmas and summer, and it always gave him a nostalgic feeling. The third thing that he loves, or should I say, had always loved, is his cute little sister, Kiara. No more, no less. She might be spoiled at times, but she still is the sweetest little girl ever. She could make his bad day into a good one. And lastly, about the things that he came to love are books. There are 5 books in his Kindle app, and he had already read each series 5 times. Since then, a lot had changed in Arnold's life. Even his passion was new. His passion for guitar started on the summer of 2016 when a family friend of his played the guitar with ease. He got so curious about it that he asked him to teach him a few chords until he could practice on his own and learn new songs, from easy to a bit hard. His sleeping pattern also changed. This senior year, he can barely sleep. Before he sleeps, he would set alarm clocks to help him wake up in the morning. He had noticed that as time passed by, during these months, alarm clocks tend to have lesser and lesser effect on him. Wrapping everything up with one last fact, we were done talking about the happenings in Arnold's past, then got to know how he is in the present. Now we should know that he is planning to be a doctor in the future. But this wasn't what he originally planned to be. When he was a kid around the age of 5, his mom had convinced him to become a priest. She had always been religious. She said it was her dream to have a child that is one. At that time, he agreed without knowing what he was agreeing to. When he was grade 6, he realized that to be a priest is a calling, and that calling had not occurred to him yet, and had made up his mind that he will not be a priest. His mom got sad, but still remained as supportive as ever.
Hey there everyone! Today I'll be sharing information about our classmate Shanessa Rose P. Chua. So what do we know about her? Well, we do know that she is one of the noisier people in class, and she has a kinda rude attitude, but she also has that kinder side when she's in a good mood.
Let's start with information that we may have not known about her when she was younger.
Did you know that when Shanessa was younger, she would perform a very weird ritual involving a Garfield stuffed toy? She would rub this stuffed toy on her face, arms, and legs before going to sleep. If she didn't do this, she would have a hard time sleeping. She also used to chew on paper as a substitute to bubblegum. She would intentionally make mistakes when she wrote on paper with a pencil because she thought it was cool when she would erase the marks with her own saliva. She was also a big fan of Jose Mari Chan. He had many songs, but Shanessa's favorite is Sing Me a Song Again, Daddy. Whenever she was in their car, she would list down the plate numbers of cars that would pass by. Lastly, for her younger years that is, she always dreamt of being a cashier because she was amused by cash registers and typing in barcodes. Now we'll proceed to her older years, around grade 7 and up. When she was in grade 7, she would make code names for several grade 10 students because of Iced Tea. You know Iced Tea? No, not that Iced Tea. This Iced Tea. Shanessa is a huge fan of Jaden. She has collections of fan merchandise. And here is a video that she treasures the most in her whole life. Shanessa has tyropophobia. And claustrophobia. Shanessa can't swallow tablets, so when she's sick, she crushes the tablets in her mouth. And it's not much of a problem for her because she likes the taste of the medicine. Well, that's everything for now, so goodbye!
Hey there everyone, I'm here to talk about our classmate Carlos Dante de Basanes. So we know that he wasn't originally from the gold section, so we may not know him as well as we know each other. So Carlos is not originally from Cebu. He was from Zamboanga City but transferred here due to some circumstances. Since he has lived most of his life not in Cebu, we are not very familiar with what he was like back in his hometown. Well, now I'll be sharing some of the things that we may have not known about him. First, did you know that he used to eat paper in his elementary days? His best friend was doing it and he was smart, so Carlos figured that if he would eat paper, he would also become smart. Well, you could say that his grades improved, but it's probably not because he ate paper. What a weirdo. Next, did you know that he hated the sight of blood, whether animal or human? He didn't like the idea of blood flowing out of an organism's body and found it disgusting. If you notice him eating his lunch, you'd see another weird fact about Carlos. He divides his rice and food almost evenly, usually into 12 pieces. He thinks that this way he can have all the flavors in every bite from his lunchbox. Well, another food fact about Carlos is that he hates condiments such as ketchup or mayonnaise. He doesn't like the smell and texture of these. So going to animals, Carlos loves animals. Particularly sloths. He found them adorable and even started researching more about them. You can say that he is obsessed with them and he hopes to have a pet sloth someday. but it may be illegal because it is an exotic pet which aren't supposed to be kept as pets. Dancing. Carlos loves to dance. He first found his passion for dancing when he arrived in Cebu and watched intermission numbers and performances. Ever since then, he started dancing around the house like no one was watching. He would face his glass sliding door and try to make short choreography for songs he felt like he could dance to. Well, back in his grade 3 days, he found slight interest in dancing. He used to be flexible and did splits, but then he didn't really continue with dancing at that time. Other than dancing, he also liked singing. There isn't a day where he doesn't sing, but he mostly does this singing at home. There, he sings like there's no tomorrow. He even did raps and other fast-paced songs. Occasionally, he would dance and sing at the same time. Wow! Thinking that he had talent in dancing and singing, Carlos also dreamt of being famous. He wanted to sing and dance like the other celebrities did so today, but he figured that he couldn't do it if he was not so confident with his talents. So going to a more serious side of Carlos. Despite having lots of close friends, he can't help but feel lonely and left out at times. He finds it hard to relate with his friends. He tries to compensate by having a cheerful attitude towards friends and smiling all the time. If you've noticed, he says hi to everyone a lot. This is one way that he can think of to try to confirm that he is a close friend to everyone. He probably just overthinks too much about what people think of him.
Here is GN. In life, we may be able to have 100 or 1,000 friends, but there is only one friend who really has loyalty on you, if you really think about it. And that is your best friend. Her name is Gabriel Ann S. Pagano, and we used to call her GN. She is someone who is sufficient in almost everything. She's funny, she's always around you whenever you need her, she's a naughty girl, and she's like a clown that makes everybody laugh just because of her funny face or expression. Yet, in all those things, there are many things that you don't know about her. First, did you know that she's a rice eater? She can eat a rice in a rice cooker. She can even determine what brand of the rice she eats. Moreover, her cravings are satisfied whenever she mixes the rice with any sweets or desserts. Crazy, right? Did you also know that she hated cats when she was still a kid? But now, she conquered her fear and became Pat, the name of her cat, a pet. Well, I think you all know this, but maybe to some of you, you don't know that Gian writes her memories every day in her diary. In there, you can see all her inside thoughts and can see how weird she really is. Another thing that for sure you don't know about her is that she doesn't want her money to be folded. So ozy, right? Furthermore, she separates the shiny coins from the dull ones and never spend it. Well, I think most of you know who her best friend is. No other than Uling. She is her happy pill and she can't live without her. And oh, I forgot to tell you that she's an avid fan of the series The Walking Dead. She has some hidden talents too. She's a swimmer when she was young, and wait, she's even a dancer. And most of all, her talent is that she makes people smile. Indeed, I can say that having her in my life is a blessing from God. She taught me how to be happy even when I have a lot of problems, and also taught me to face those problems when I'm ready.
We all know this girl. Obviously, she's not the shy type. She's jamming, friendly, and sociable. Meet Brittany Keen Bicabasa, Brittany for short. We all know her as one of the talkative students in 10 St. John. Well, you do agree with me, right? Yes, 101%. Each and every one of us have a lot of secrets. Everybody has a lot of secrets unspoken. Do you want to know some of her secrets? Let's spill the beans. Did you know? She is a supportive mother. Her mother always supports her in everything she does. Like, let's say, for example, her mother really wants her to have a boyfriend. Crazy, isn't it? Aside from that, whenever she feels down, her mother motivates her to try and try again until she succeeds. A quote once said, "Don't let fear stop you from doing the things you love." Another interesting fact about her is that she can't wake up with an alarm clock. No matter how loud the ringtone rings, she can't get up in bed. Indeed, she sleeps like there's no tomorrow, just like a dead person found in a coffin, perhaps. She even owned a pet tarantula named DJ. Well, obviously, it stands for Daniel Padilla, her beloved dream boy. It was a couple of years back then, 2012 to be exact, since she started to admire Daniel. She describes him as, "Nasayo na ang lahat." Lol. Okay, enough. Aside from that, Brittany really loves to sing. Did you know that wherever she goes, singing is really her routine? Whether it's a Bruno Mars, a Lady Gaga, a Taylor Swift, or any other artist's song. She even has secret voice records found in her phone because she believes that she is a good singer. Try to check her phone. I admit there are a lot of song records found. And although she has a lot of secrets to tell, I would stop here. Indeed, Brittany is one of my greatest treasure in life. She has been there for me through my ups and downs. She never fails to make me smile, and that smile made others smile too. I am very thankful to have her as my best friend. And although there are billions of friendships, ours is my favorite.
My partner is a girl who has a lot of ambitions in life. She is a short, small, yet strong woman who never gives up on her dreams. She is China Glyph and Pipito. China loves to collect and to read pop fiction books. She's also fond of making poems in her spare time. She loves to take selfies every day for her 2017 selfie compilation. Now, here are some interesting facts that you don't know about her. Ever wondered why her name is so unique? She was named after the singer China Phillips and the actress Drew Blythe Barrymore. She enrolled at nursery at an early age since her parents got scared that she will be called Yungit in Cebuano. She is naughty during her elementary days. Every year, her mom will be called by her teacher because of China's behavior. In her spare time, she loves to go cafe hopping alone and read novels. She enrolled at swimming classes at 4 years old since she was afraid of the water but overcame her fear after joining the classes. She can't sleep if she doesn't put lotion on her feet. She really loves Coke. She drinks Coke 2 to 3 times a week. She's a dog lover. Her pet dog's name is Sugar because of its hair color. Her favorite song as a child was Dancing Queen by ABBA. She always sings this song at her karaoke's. She has big tonsils, so she is only allowed to eat a little amount of sweets. She is anemic, but this does not stop her from doing outdoor activities like hiking and jogging. Ah, she hates raisins and olives. She became amoebic when her Lola let her drink tap water when she was a child. And since then, she isn't allowed to drink tap water because she will get sick and vomit. There was a time when her sister became an honor student and she received many medals. She asked for a medal, but her sister did not give her one and said that she should study hard and get one for herself. This became China's inspiration to do her best in school.
My partner is a boy who was born to become a leader. He is a brave, an independent man, yet also a kind-hearted person. He is Gerald Nitz R. Ponce. Gerald is active on social media and loves to post his day-to-day encounters. He loves to create and post hugot lines. He is even called as Hugot King ng 10 St. John. Now, here are some interesting facts that you don't know about him. He was named after his cousin, Gerald Fritz, who is from Cagayan de Oro City. When he was still in kindergarten, his Lola tied him up to their jackfruit tree because he didn't want to go to school and he kept on crying. His relatives say that when he was little, they were astonished because he spoke like a grown man. He was also naughty during his elementary days, and he even kissed his crush on her cheek. He had his first girlfriend when he was in grade 5. He loves to listen and sing original Pinoy music, or OPM. When he was a child, he dreamed of becoming a priest, but as time passed by, he decided to become a teacher instead, because he loves teaching children. He is allergic with so many things except food. He is allergic to dogs, cats, cockroaches, dust, molds, and ants. He loves to go to different cafes and order his favorite drink, Java chip or green tea frappe. Every time he is alone at home, he always stays in the room, listen to OPM, or read Wattpad stories. He keeps on overthinking, and he even attempted to hold his breath and cover his face with a pillow. But one thing he always dreamed of having is a best friend.
She is pretty, cheerful, talented, and unique. She is Eliza Kim P. Romeo, my best friend, and she's one of a kind. Some may know her as a friend, classmate, schoolmate, or a sister, but for me, she is all of the above. She is like a sister I never had. We all know her as a simple schoolgirl, but there is a lot more things about her. So here are some facts about Eliza that we don't know. Eliza, preferably called Kim, was born on the 24th day of October on the year 2000. She got this gorgeous curly hair, long lashes, and a cute little face. Back when she was a kid, she is fond of playing with pogs and marbles with her cousin and neighbors. She says she hates pink when she was young. She has an unusual favorite color, which is maroon and blue-black. Kim likes to thumbs up her finger and only stopped when she reached grade 5. She have two stitches, one on her right leg and one on her head. She got the stitch on her leg when she slipped and hit her leg on a chair. Well, she got the stitch on her head when she slipped again and hit her head on a cabilla. Despite the fact that she had this dreadful experience, she grew up to be a happy girl. One thing that I found unique about her is that unlike a typical teenager, she doesn't have Twitter or Instagram because she believes it is a waste of time. I think she is right, but I bet most of us do it otherwise. One thing she loves is biking. She bikes with her father and sister during weekends and holidays. She have gone to places like Busay, Consolacion, Lapu-Lapu, and Olongo Island. Amazing, right? She usually goes to Busay with her dad and sister for late night talks and to enjoy the view of the city lights. They also consider Busay as their happy place. Aside from biking, she loves to go on adventures such as waterfall hopping and canyoneering in Bajag. Not everyone has a great courage like her to do these things. Kim really likes to try new stuff she haven't tried yet. For example, inhaling helium from a balloon and speak like a chipmunk. And one last fact about her she can literally sleep anywhere, in the jeepney, classroom, or even in the gym. Knowing all these unique things about her, she is truly an amazing girl, and I am indeed lucky to have her as my best friend.
We all know her as a pretty, sweet, kind, and smart girl. She is no other than Lieutenant Colonel Kyle B. Visitacion, the second highest ranking officer in CAT Batch 2016-2017. We may know Kyle, but there are still ample of things we don't know about her. She was born and raised in Busay, Cebu City. Her name was supposed to be Veronica Marie, but her parents hesitated because it sounded maldita, so they came up with Kyle instead. Her nickname is Kana, which is derived from the food Pongkan. When she was about 5, she already memorized the song titled The Greatest Love of All, and she loved to dance when the song Aserehe is being played. She even attended voice lessons in Salonga when she was 10 years old, but she usually skips her sessions. Her asthma was at worst before that her parents would rush her to the hospital in the middle of the night. They tried several methods to cure her asthma, and only her neighbor who knows how to massage was the only one who lessened the occurrence of her attacks. Kyle is afraid of worms because, believe it or not, there was a time that a worm literally came out of her body when she was still young. She even had 2 earring holes on her left ear because she was very hyper when she got her ears pierced. Kyle didn't have any idea how to bike nor to swim. Her knees always sound every time she bends them. She has a habit of disposing her waist every after breakfast. Weird, right? Now, let's talk about what Kyle really likes the most. Kyle loves sweets, and Snickers and Trinkles are her favorite. She really, really loves milk for breakfast, lunch, even dinner, especially when it's served with hard-boiled eggs. Her favorite main course is adobong squid. She considers pink as the best color in the world. With 5 years of knowing Kyle, truly, I can say that she is indeed, without a doubt, a supercalifragilisticexpialidocious person whom I won't be able to forget, and I feel very blessed to be her best friend.
Thanks for watching! Bye!
Liam is my best friend in the entire world. We've known each other for 4 years. And like everyone else, she has secrets too. Now I'm going to tell you all about her. Liam was born and raised in Bacolod City, and she is fluent in Hiligaynon, or most commonly known as Ilonggo, because she lived there for 12 years before she transferred here in Cebu. Her dad started working abroad before she turned 1 year old, so her mom was the one who raised her, and her mom influenced her to like movies such as Harry Potter and Star Wars. Speaking of Star Wars, did you know that her nickname Leia was inspired from the character Princess Leia? Anyways, she has many skills and talents. She started singing when she was 4, dancing when she was 5, and acting when she was 10. She was also a ballerina and a gymnast. Did you also know that when she was in grade school, she always got sent to the principal's office? This is because she always had fights with other people. When she was little, her left thumb used to be broken, but at the age of 12, her sister slammed her finger on the door, and ever since, her thumb was normal again. Did you also know that Liam likes to read? She reads books anywhere, like literally anywhere. Because she grew up with boys, Liam is very fond of video games. But her favorite games are racing games or games which involve cars. Did you know that Liam knows how to drive a car? She begged her mom to teach her to drive both automatic and manual cars because she wants to have her own car once she reaches 18. Did you know that Liam has a sweet tooth? Liam would eat desserts every day if she could, but she is not allowed to eat sweets, so she is kind of the rebel right now. We all know that Liam loves to swim, but when she was 3 years old, her mom enrolled her to swimming classes, but Liam was afraid of the water because she believed that there would be sharks, alligators, or piranhas in the water. So she would cry every time she touches the water. But during grade 2, she became jealous of her cousins because they would swim without her. So she asked her mom if she could join swimming lessons during the summer. Her coach was an Olympic swimmer, and he encouraged her to join swimming competitions. Now, Liam is a great swimmer.
My best friend is Matthew James D. Lazala, or MJ for short. We are really close, and I know a lot of stuff about him that you may not know. And I am here to tell you all about it. MJ was born in Cebu City. There was a time when his mom left him to his grandmother for a week, and when his parents returned, he only remembered her sister and forgot his parents. Funny, right? MJ and his sister are so close that if they fight, they'll be okay in less than 5 seconds. He really loves his sister very much, but there isn't a day that they won't talk. Anyways, MJ is a really kind person, but he's the shy type. He's an introvert, but when you get close with him, you'll see an entirely different person. He gets so loud at times and even annoying, but he's still the kind person you know. Did you know that his hair was straight before? He said it just suddenly became curly back when he was still a child. MJ likes to play shooting horror games, Tekken, and the like. He tried basketball summer classes for 2 years, but he was never interested in it. Instead of sports, he likes to draw. He can draw on paper and on the computer too. He has a YouTube channel which contains his processes of drawing in the computer. Speaking of computers, he really likes to play computer games. He still plays a game which he played since he was in grade 1. Another fact about MJ is that he can't swim, except when he has floaters. He is also scared of butterflies, moths, or any insects except ants. It may not be clear because he always hides his feelings. As I said, he only shows his feelings when you two are very close. And as far as I know, he has only a few friends, and that he is thankful that they are the ones that he trusts. MJ really likes to dance. In grade 3, he joined the dance club. But he stopped dancing for a while because he was the only guy and he was made to dance girl dances. Because of that, he was teased and was afraid to dance again. He only tried to dance again in 6th grade in the hip-hop competition in CMLI. He also joined the Kanye competition from grade 8 to 10 and won 3 times straight. The latest competition he joined this year is Music in Motion. They didn't win, but it was still a fun experience, as he says. Now, he says he has no plans to quit dancing anymore.
This is my friend Carl Fanzine A. Ompad. He might look gloomy on the outside, but he is very energetic. Although he is very lazy, he is still very smart and reliable. He wants to become an engineer in the future. Here are some things he likes doing. He loves to play the piano. He also loves to play guitar. And like me, he also plays computer games and rides the bicycle. But did you know these facts about Carl? He actually does not know how to swim, but he always likes to go to the pool. He might not look like it, but he likes taking selfies. Carl has a weird sleeping cycle. When he gets in the car, he immediately sleeps. He wakes up when he arrives at home and then sleep once again on his bed. He wakes up around 11 p.m. and that is when he is going to take his dinner. Weird, right? And also, his sleeping position is like this. And if I am afraid of lizards, he is afraid of spiders. Even the smallest of the spiders. He finds them creepy because of their long legs. One fact of Carl also is that he loves eating and savoring cup noodles. Since elementary, he is fond of cup noodles. And lastly, his ultimate super duper secret is that he secretly eats flowers and papers. What a weird guy! Well, these are just some facts that maybe you don't know about Carl.
His name is King Francis A. Rebusit. He is a cheerful and joyful person. Despite all the problems and misadventures in life, he still tends to smile and be happy. He wants to make others happy and mark smiles in their faces. His dream job is to become a successful seafarer. He loves listening to music. Playing computer games and biking. King is very diligent in his studies. King is also a loving person. He is always there for you right when you need him. Maybe some of you already know a lot of things about him, but there are things about him that you probably don't know. First of all, he loves cats because for him, they are cute and adorable. Believe it or not, they have 11 cats in their house and still counting. Most people are afraid of cockroaches, but do you know what he fears the most? Lizards. He has phobia towards lizards. He has a phobia towards lizards because he finds them creepy, especially their skins. When they get in contact with him, he doesn't know what to do. Also, one weird fact about him is that he sleeps with 5 pillows. With an additional hot dog pillow. For him, he can't sleep properly when he don't have that many pillows. These are just some eerie facts about my partner that maybe you don't know about.
Jazette and Irma first met each other when they became classmates.
They were seated beside each other due to the alphabetical arrangement.
Months have passed and their bond became stronger than ever.
After all the laughs and tests of friendship, there are still things that these two did not know about each other.
And even the rest of their classmates.
This is my friend Jazette. She has proven to me that just like Miss Pia Wurzbach, she's also confidently beautiful with a heart. She may look intimidating at first, but once you get to know her, you'll discover how funny and wacky she is. The youngest of 4 kids, Jazette Carmel Cartagena Saison, was born on the 28th of June 2000. Her mother actually forced giving birth to her the day before, so she and her ate will have the same birthday. Well, that obviously didn't work. She doesn't have much baby photos because they were lost to a fire in her grandmother's house. When she was still a baby, she tried eating her own poop because she thought it was chocolate. Adorable yet gross. Jacetta's tried singing, dancing, playing the piano, and swimming. However, she was very devastated to find out that singing just wasn't meant for her. This girl loves going on adventures. She likes traveling and taking extreme rides. In fact, she's been to at least 10 different places, both local and international destinations. Because of traveling, she has started collecting money from different countries as her souvenir. Jacette claims that she has the weirdest laugh. She is said to be the corniest in her barkada. She hates boys. She doesn't feel comfortable mingling with them. She's been through one relationship in her life and it lasted only for a day. Jacette broke up with the guy over a text message. Hi, poor lad. No one loves hygiene more than Jacette. One of her unique habits is spraying alcohol on her feet before she goes to sleep. Jacette has claustrophobia. She hates the darkness and cramped spaces. This is why she has a flashlight beside her bed and another one that she brings wherever she goes in case there's a brownout. Her precocious experience was drowning in the pool when she was younger. She thought it was the last moment of her life. Despite being traumatized by the experience, she overcame her fear and learned swimming afterwards. She's witty, beautiful, and fierce. She's Jacette.
Her mother calls her baby rabbit and says she's quite crybaby back then. However, she grew up to be such a happy and cheerful girl. And her name is Irma Mae Sanchez. We all know her as an independent and hardworking lady. She's definitely an achiever and she makes sure that she does her best in everything. However, she's also shy and timid at times, especially when it comes to showing her talents. In fact, you may not know that Irma can actually sing pretty well.
Loving can hurt. Loving can hurt sometimes. But it's the only thing that I know. When it gets hard, well, it can get hard sometimes. It is the only thing that makes us feel love.
And she can strut the runway like a true supermodel. She also likes adventure and has been to 4 countries all over the world. There are also a lot of interesting facts about Irma that many of you may not know, and one of which is the fact that she hates chicken skin. She also hates the strong smell of perfume. Irma also has a signature dance move called the shoulder twist. Irma is also a huge fan of NBA, and her favorite team is the Golden State Warriors. She's also afraid of strong winds due to her Super Typhoon Yolanda experience back when she was still in Leyte. So yes, she has tons of skills and abilities, yet one thing she can't do is swim. She once drowned when she was merely a child, and since then, she never gets comfortable swimming in deep waters. I can say that despite her simple and vulnerable appearance, Irma is strong and is a fighter. Indeed,
We can never really judge a book by its cover.
Smart, funny, weird, and pretty. That is what we describe my partner, Mathea Gabriel Irana Ruiz, or simply, Matt. There are many things that we don't know about Matt, and I'm here to shed light to some of them. Matt was born to Mark and Geneva Ruiz on April 16, 2001, and she was the eldest among three, Miggy and Mako Ruiz. As a daughter, Mathea is very close to both of her parents. Her family is young-looking, especially the side of her mom. Here is her grandmother, who lives in Canada and is 70 years old. And this is her grandfather, who was a corps commander in his school. As a sister, she really loves squishing her sister Miggy and her brother Mako. When she was young, she didn't know how to tie her hair. Ironic, right? She also engaged to Taekwondo and was a yellow belter. Like other people, she also owns three big aquariums, all full with fishes. And when she was young, she was allergic to jewelry that was not pure gold and silver, or she would have rashes. This girl knew how to play the piano and was also addicted to anime. She started watching anime during the third grade with her dad. She also hates cold water and shopping because she gets tired following her mom everywhere. Her mother is a baker and she helps her decorate cakes and pastries at her spare time. And because of this, she hates the taste of chocolate and vanilla. Because her mother lets her taste every flavor she can make. Like many other people, Mathea was also bullied. You know why? Because her friend was jealous of her looks, and not to mention having a lot of admirers back at her days. This experience made her realize that there are just some people who will always see life as a competition and not an adventure.
Hi, Matt.
Hi, Kat.
Let's play a game of fast talk.
Okay.
Chocolate or vanilla?
None.
Why?
I don't like.
Vanilla?
No.
Chocolate?
No.
Why?
The reason is because, yeah, as you know, my mom's a baker. And napulaan ako sa mga cakes. I'm like the taste tester.
Ah. Veggies or meat?
Veggies. And
why?
Fish. Meat is nice, but in my family, we have this tradition of like eating vegetables every day. And I kind of, you know, lamian ko na.
Dentist or doctor?
None.
Why?
The doctor, I hate needles. Tusok,
The dentist?
The dentist, I hate it because, as you can see, sa una kay, the first time I had my tooth pulled out, it was so sakit. And I accidentally kicked the dentist. May gani wala yung nabuak, pero like, na-trauma na ako, so like, yeah, I've started changing kay, the reason why I got these braces. It's because, you know, I don't go to the dentist niya, na-deform na akong tooth. And so, I've learned my lesson, I went to the dentist, pick up courage niya. That's how I got my braces niya. Look, it's really deformed.
These are just some of the facts that we know about Matt. And if we want to know her deeply, might as well approach her and ask.
Live my day as if it was the last. Live my day as if there was no past. Doing it all night, all summer. Doing it the way I wanna. Yeah, I'ma dance my heart out till the dawn.
Hi guys, this is Kathleen. She's a girl with a great fashion sense. She has a great voice.
The snow plays the red in this world. Your eyes are where I'm lost it. Underneath your shape to live, we're dancing all alone.
She's friendly, she opens up about anything.
You know, okay, let's reach out right here. You know, I'm her crazy best friend and I wanna smash her.
She knows her comedy. And she's also smart. Like, really smart. Other than that, she is very romantic. Why did I say that?
My attention. I've never seen a man with so-
Let's take a sneak peek, shall we?
Your spots in your eyes, I don't wanna wait for tonight. So I'm daydreaming with my chin in the palm of my hands about you, you, and I'm in your cafe. Daydreaming with my
Time's been ticking, hearts are running. Think that Cupid's up to something. You ask me how I feel, I say nothing. But lately colors seem so bright and the stars light up the night.
The reason why she sometimes looks at the soccer field for no reason is because here are some facts that you don't know about her. She was born in August 10, 2000 by Richard and Enriquita Texon. Her bloodline was that of Mercado. In other words, she is a distant relative of Jose Rizal. Kathleen is the eldest out of four children. Her siblings are John, Erica, and Jico. When she was 5 years old, she hit her head on the edge of the table. This made a scar on her beautiful face, specifically her forehead. When she was 8 years old, a motorcycle had hit her so bad that she was paralyzed for 3 days. The proof is the scar on her right knee. We all know that Kathleen loves playing volleyball, right? But you might not know this. When she was 10 years old, her love for volleyball had led her to an accident. Thus, it made a scar on her left hand. We all know that Kathleen loves travel, right? Is that really how it started? Nope. In fact, Kathleen was afraid of the heights and the dark. Her turning point in life was when she stayed there for 2 days in Mount Agudo. On that trip, she conquered her fears. This is when her love for travel and freedom started. Kathleen was a fan of dragons. In fact, she had an imaginary friend dragon named Leo. He was a dragon whose color was blue. There is always a time when a person feels down, sensitive, and emotional. She drowns herself in thoughts,
thoughts of committing suicide, but she gets back up again and faces life head on. Here are some food facts. Kathleen never eats pasta, so if you hate her, serve her pasta. She also doesn't know how to eat chicken, so if you want to blackmail her, then think about chicken. It's weird how she eats hamburger without mayonnaise and ketchup. How can one not see the beauty of mayonnaise and ketchup? Well, my taste is mine and her taste is hers.
I got this feeling inside my bones. It goes electric, wavy when I turn it on. Off from my city, off from my home. We're flying up, no ceiling when we in our zone.